Hello, and welcome to the Queen's Access Podcast. It's so lovely to have you here, and I hope you find this a useful resource in learning more about life at Oxford, but more specifically about life at the Queen's College. My guests this week are Charlotte Murphy, a second-year German student, and Katie Bellock, a second-year studying English and French, and they are the food reps for the JCR this year. We'll have a chat about all things food at Queen's. My apologies for any poor audio. These interviews have all been conducted over Zoom and the internet connection isn't always completely reliable. For a transcript of this episode, please visit the Queen's website. I hope you enjoy.
Hi guys, it's so lovely to have you here. To start us off, I was hoping each of you could tell me a little bit about your Queen's journey. So how you ended up in college. Katie, do you want to start us off?
I first saw Queen's on an open day. And I think what attracted me to it first was just, like, obviously it's a really pretty college. It's very central. And then when I kind of got home and did some more research, I realised it has, like, a focus for my course, which is, like, English and modern languages. And also I heard everywhere that it was just a really, really friendly college, which obviously... to me sounded like a really good thing.
Brilliant. Yeah, so then did you apply to Queen's directly? Did you like get pulled up for an interview or
so I just had interviews at Queen's and I stayed here for interviews.
Brill. Charlotte, what about you?
So mine's kind of a funny story because basically at the end of year 10 my school did mocks and then just kind of randomly they decided who did well in them and then sent them on the September open day to Oxford, and we didn't have any idea what was going on. I had no idea about the college system, about anything to do with Oxford, and so me and my friend were really like scared. We were just wandering around Oxford aimlessly, and then we saw like balloons outside of Queen's and we thought, well, let's just go through this gate. And then we just got like taken on a tour of Queen's, and that was kind of the only college that I saw that day, and it was like the only thing that I was aware of to do with Oxford. And then when I actually started to think about seriously applying, Queen's came up again. Like I met the tutor for my course, and it just seemed like really perfect, and it was just really nice.
Oh, lovely. So then were you the same as Katie? You applied directly to Queen's?
Yeah, same.
Okay, so for each of you then, can you just give me an idea of what a week looks like for you in Oxford, like academically, socially, personally, any of that kind of thing? So Charlotte, do you want to start this time?
Yeah, so every week I have an essay or two, like depending on the week. In my first term, I had two essays a week, which was really fun. But then, in second term, it got a bit lighter. And then every week, I also have two translations, one into English and one from German to English, and one from English to German. And then I have four tutorials, and then two lectures, and then just one class. So there's like, I'd say there's quite a few contact hours, but there's not as many as sciences or anything like that. And so you still have plenty of time to just like work by yourself and just do what you want with your day, which I really like. And then like socially, I just spend a lot of time with friends and go out quite a lot at night. And obviously every single day I go to hall, have my lunch in hall. That's really nice because it's quite social. And then JCRT at 4 o'clock I do every day. Yeah.
Oh, brilliant. Katie, how about you?
So work-wise, probably pretty similar. Like usually an essay a week, a translation, some reading, a tutor, and like a few classes and lectures and stuff. And then kind of outside of that, going out a couple of times a week. Spending time with friends a lot. So we do like a lot of movie nights and stuff. Or we'll like go to Beer Cellar, which is our college bar, where you can like play pool and stuff. So me and Charlotte have like a bit of a pool rivalry going on. it's just really fun.
Yeah, there was one night
I love that.
Where there was like it was a Saturday night, so there was quite a few families in, and me and Katie were had the pool table for like half an hour, and all these like dads were watching us and like trying to cheer us on because we couldn't do it. It was so
awful.
I would say that's like one of the best things is not only since going to Oxford has my chemistry knowledge increased, my ability to play pool. I mean, it was abysmal to begin with, but it's definitely gone up thanks to BC.
Definitely.
Okay, fab. Well, Charlotte, you mentioned eating in hall. So that brings us quite nicely onto what the main topic of this episode is, which is all things food at Queen's. So I want to ask you both, how do meals and meal choices generally work at Queen's? So Katie, do you want to start?
Yeah, so breakfast and lunch are kind of done in like a canteen style. So you just choose what you want and it's served to you. So you like queue up and everything and then you pay at the end. And then dinner is kind of done as like a booking on system. So you can book on to dinner and that's quite nice because it's actually served to you. Like you all sit down and then all your food comes out. So with kind of choosing there, you can choose like either a veggie or a meat meal when you book on, or if you have like specific dietary requirements like you're vegan or gluten-free or something, the kitchen will already know about that and they'll have prepared you something.
Charlotte, do you have anything you want to add to that?
I think Katie's covered quite a lot, but I guess in terms of like food next year in hall, we're quite excited because there's a new chef arriving, so yeah, it's going to be nice to see what new food he introduces. But yeah, I do love food in hall. It's really good.
Yeah, it is. So we talked then briefly about dietary requirements. So what's it like eating at Queen's as somebody with a dietary requirement? So Charlotte, do you want to chip in there?
So at breakfast and lunch, where you have like the canteen style thing, in front of every kind of food option, there's allergy cards so people can see if it's suitable for them to eat. And then also there's always staff there that serve you the food when you ask for it. So you can always ask them if it's suitable for you. And they're usually really good. Like some of my friends are vegan and the staff like know now, and they just direct them to what's vegan and what isn't. Like they're really good with helping you to figure it out. And then obviously at dinner, like Katie said, the kitchen will already know if you have dietary requirements because you inform them before you arrive. So just whenever you book onto dinner, you'll be like served something that's suitable for you.
Katie, do you have anything you want to put in there?
No, I think Charlotte's pretty much covered everything.
Okay, brilliant. Well, I'd like to just add in that I do have a nut allergy, which makes me so fun at meals. but one of the things Charlotte said about you, the fact that you're from the kitchen, it's also really good because at the start of the year, I got given a card that says my name and then says no nuts. So every served meal I go to, I just put that down in front of me. And it means that like the servers know not to serve me anything with nuts in and things like that. So it's like a very reassuring system. I know I'm not going to eat anything that's going to cause anything dangerous to happen, which is brilliant. Yeah. So you guys run JCRT every day at 4:00. Can you explain what that is and why it's so amazing? So Katie, do you want to start?
Yeah, so like you said, every day at 4 p.m. Everyone comes into the JCR, which is like our common room, because we sell loads and loads of snacks at cost price, including cheese on toast, which is a bit of like a Queen's favourite. And it's just so lovely. Like it's a really fun kind of social break from work, and then because it happens every day, it's like you can just see your friends. It's also quite nice, you can see, because everyone comes from college, so you'll see people from other years and stuff, so that's really nice to kind of like make friends with like older years, which I think kind of contributes to like the friendly vibe that Queen's is kind of known for. Also has like lots of like throwback snacks, which are really fun, so like we sell like Dib Dabs and Flumps and stuff, so yeah, no, it's just really nice.
Yeah, definitely. I love JCRT. Charlotte, do you want to put anything in?
I think one of the great things about JCRT at Queen's is that we have it every single day, like even weekends and things. And I think most colleges have a welfare tea like once a week or something. And I honestly don't know how they cope. Like, I just love my JCRT. And it's just great because, like, I mean, sometimes I miss lunch and things like that. And you can always, you know, if you're hungry, there's always guaranteed you'll be able to get food. And it's just nice to see your friends. Like sometimes you don't see people until the JCRT. And it's just a really nice way to like guarantee that you'll see people, guarantee that you'll have an intake. And also a great thing about JCRT is that you can work it. So you actually do get food, but it's quite a good wage. I think it works out at, I think it's £6 half an hour or £5 half an hour or something, which... Yeah, it's really good. I worked it last term and it's just a really good way of just like getting a little bit of money in.
Yeah, definitely, because I think some people get put off by the fact that you can't get a job if you're an Oxford student. But actually, there are loads of opportunities for things like working JCRT, working behind the bar in the beer cellar. There, and then student ambassadors for interviews and open days get paid. So there can be a lot of experiences for term time work that very easily fits into your schedule. So one of the things Oxford's very famous for is its formal dinners. So what are these like at Queen's? Charlotte, do you want to start?
Yeah, so at Queen's, we have formal dinner every single week. So it's every Saturday. And it's really nice because you can dress up with your friends and you can have a nice meal. And the food is a little bit more like fancy than at dinner and lunch. So you get to try new things that you might not have tried any time before. Like, I think there was, what was it, like guinea fowl once or something like that. I know duck was on there as well. I know it's not that fancy, but I've never had that before. So yeah, formal dinners are a little bit more expensive than normal hall dinners. So hall dinners are about £4 and formals are about £8. But also you can bring family and friends from outside of Oxford to formals, which is really cute because you can like introduce them to like the quaint little sides of Oxford that not a lot of people get to see. Yeah, it's just really nice.
Oh, fantastic. Katie, do you want to add anything in?
Maybe just after formal hall, lots of people go to beer cellar, so that's always really fun, even if you haven't been to formal. And like the jukebox is always like playing something, people are playing pool, like everyone's chatting. It's just a really nice kind of vibe. Yeah.
Okay, did you want to add anything in about the Buttery maybe?
Oh yeah, yeah, of course. Yeah, so the Buttery sells bottles of wine. Yeah, and you're free to like buy those beforehand and then you can take them into formal and like drink a bit with the meal, which is really nice.
And they also get stamped, which means that you can take them down to the beer cellar afterwards. And I think now they've introduced a rule that you can take one bottle of your own alcohol from outside into formal. You can't take that to beer cellar, but you can take it into formal. Yeah, and that's reasonably priced.
Yeah, it is reasonably priced. And I think what's cute about it as well is that it has like Queen's branding on it. So
yeah,
if my dad was to get a bottle of that, like he'd probably just display it in the kitchen or something.
I love that. Forget buying Oxford merch, get the Queen's wine bottle.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely.
So another form of formal dinner that we have is we have subject dinners in Hillary term. So what was your experience of these? Katie, do you want to start?
Yeah, so yeah, these are so much fun. So it's kind of everyone from your subjects, including your tutors, you'll get dressed up and you have kind of like a fancy meal. So yeah, it feels kind of like weird to like socialize with your tutors and stuff outside of kind of contact hours, and also like get drunk with your tutors is very Oxford. But it's really, really fun. So me and Charlotte went to the Modern Languages one together, where the fourth years, or like the finalists, they sit with kind of like the main tutors at like a different table, which is really cute because obviously they've like done like 4 years together. It's their last year. And some people kind of say speeches. And then afterwards you go to beer cellar, classic. But yeah, it's really fun. We also have one for English as well, which is called the Yule Feast because it's kind of, they have it around Christmas. And it's like a traditional medieval themed feast, which feels very, very Oxford, but it was so much fun. They had like traditional food, songs and traditions and stuff. Yeah, that was really good.
Oh, nice. Charlotte, do you have anything you want to add in there?
I think Kate is coming. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I remember one of my favourite things about subject dinner was watching two of my tutors get really competitive at pool. That was very entertaining. And they had us like each cheering them on depending on like whose sub-discipline you preferred. It was like the most nerdy thing ever, but it was great. So I think we've kind of really covered quite a lot of the food aspect of life at Queen's. So just to close, I'd like to ask you each a question that I ask everybody, because I think that it's a really nice way of getting to know more about the college. So for each of you, what is your favourite thing about college and why? Charlotte, do you want to go first?
So I know that everyone from every college and every uni says this, but I think Queen's has to be like full of the friendliest people that I've ever met. It's just so nice and welcoming. And I really can't imagine being anywhere else. Like, I just made so many friends here and met so many nice people. And I just think it really is what makes Queen's so special, because it just, the people really do make Queen's feel like I'm at home, and it made me settle in so much quicker. It was just so lovely. And yeah, I just think that makes Queen's really different and special.
Oh, lovely. Katie, how about you?
It sounds a bit cringe, but like, I would say definitely the people as well. I think like there's like a perception of Oxford as like very elitist or whatever, but Queen's is just, I immediately felt at ease when I kind of got to uni, because everyone is just so lovely. Yeah. People are just so friendly. Definitely the people.
I would
agree. I think that, yeah, like that's a really common thing that people say about Queen's, is it's a super friendly college and it has a really nice vibe, which I think is definitely true, even though obviously we're not biased in any way. So thank you so much for speaking to me. You guys have been really interesting, and I'm sure everybody who listened feels they really have their A to Z of food at Queen's now, which is perfect. So yeah, thank you so much for being here, and I'll speak to you both soon.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Thank you so much to Charlotte and Katie for that interesting conversation, and a massive thank you to all of you who listened. There are loads more Access resources on the Queen's College website at www.queens.ox.ac.uk/access-outreach, and you can find out more about the college in general through its website, Twitter and Instagram, including on the Access Twitter @Queen's Outreach. That's all from me. Have a lovely week, and hopefully I'll see you again soon.